Luke, I guess, for the past year or two, has already had the concept in mind to do just a one track that was a complete album, and kind of have it in movements.
After the experience of seeing the incident from Porcupine Tree twice live, within maybe a year, Wilson came two times in Montreal, and first time was at the Metropolis. Like, it's more of a standing up, you know, venue. But the other one was at Place des Arts, which is more of a, you know, like a concert hall, you know, with seats and everything, and the experience. I mean, nothing wrong watching the show standing, but for some reason, the experience was different, you know, the second time around, and knowing the record very, very well, and just having them perform from start to finish, like a film or like a story. I really like the storytelling aspect of that show, and it really, really triggered something in me.
That's like where his brain has been musically. He's been really excited about like form, like long form in music, and he's been really excited about like dynamics and texture, and like not having a death metal song be just the same tone and dynamic the whole time.
When I say storytelling, it's not about words yet, even it has to work music by itself. So
originally we had the idea in the very beginning, before we had any music written, that maybe Luke would start the piece with like the first 10 minutes, Colin would pick up from there, and then I would finish, you know? And we would kind of, I guess create themes on the other person's material and then take it from there. It seemed like an interesting concept, but really what ended up happening was Luke wrote the first 20 minutes, said, check this out. And then we all started working on the first 20 minutes together, and then he was really inspired by how that was going, and then he wrote the last 10 minutes of it like pretty quickly afterwards.
It got me out of my comfort zone, you know, for structure. Because to me, also doing composition, sometimes there's more work into structure than actual theme composition, like as riffs. You know, you can have the best riff, but if they're all put together the wrong way, it's not going to work. So structure is a very important aspect for me.
Yeah, the way it works is he'll send us something that's like, his parts are finished, the structure's finished, and then we have complete freedom to write whatever we want over top of that.
The fact that it's being a one long song, there's not much part, let's say after 10 minutes, you're gonna hear riffs from the beginning again. No, it's like one long phrase. So there's not even, I feel it's catchy music, but it's not written like a very A, B, A structure, whatever, you know? So it's like one long breath.
When Luke sends us, he'll send us a song idea first, but fully mapped out and organized, like not just like here's some riffs I have, it's like here's either a whole song or here's like the first 20 minutes of a song, in this case, and he sends tabs for it, you know, which is really helpful. I just basically, usually, even though he plays 7-string, I play 6-string, I can't play the notes he plays down on the 7-string, but he'll still send me the tabs anyway, and I'll learn them, just to learn them first and get a grasp on the rhythm and stuff, and then from there I kind of use that as like my source material to then build my parts. Sometimes there's moments where I'm like, that riff, I want to follow that, like I want to have, we'll play this in there. Most of the time I'm always thinking about like how I'll add to a part, you know, or like what kind of harmony or whatever.
Even on this one, I pretty much program all the drums to give Patrice a very good idea of what I heard in mind. I mean, and then he's free to do whatever he wants, but instead of being in the rehearsal room and say, what about here and vocally explaining everything, you know? I just wrote everything down, guitars, tabbed everything down for strings, and gave that to Patrice, gave that to Colin and Kevin, and they do all the arrangement over what I wrote.
And then I took that demo with drum machine and guitar, wrote bass parts over it, and then I changed a lot of the drum parts, just playing my keyboard with a drum sound, like super sloppy hilarious sounding drum ideas, just to like come up with a different idea for like a feel of a riff. Like he would have like maybe a backbeat, and I would hear it as being more of like a fast death metal drumming part.
But what's interesting is that Colin and I write our own parts to Luke's part individually without hearing what the other guy's gonna come up with. So that gets interesting sometimes when I've written all my parts to Luke's part and Colin's written all his bass parts to Luke's part. But since Colin and I are both writing such individual parts based on Luke's parts, sometimes that combination of all three things can be totally insane. And sometimes not in a good way, and we have to change them. But most of the time, it's kind of amazing how strangely it all fits together. You know? And I think that's what gives it sort of the sound that it has.
Colin likes to odd my phrasing here and there to bring a nice detail in the writing, because of course I have my how can I say that, way of writing things, you know. But him, he's more odd. Me, I'll be more square writing, so sometimes he's gonna odd things up here and there.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I guess I do like it. But that's kind of like that's not something specific to Gorguts. I think like whenever I'm writing music with anybody and they bring in something for me to add my parts to, my reaction is very often to write a counterpart and not just to play the same thing.
No, I think with fitting in with Luke as far as like writing guitar parts with him, I mean, it felt natural from the beginning. And I think for Colin too, writing bass parts.
You know, I'd listen to a part and I'd think, you know, I don't know, there's not even that much thought involved. The way I write is super intuitive when I'm writing on the instrument. And even when I'm writing the Behold stuff and it's not on the instrument, it's still really intuitive.
Maybe like when we first joined and we're writing Colored Sands, but I think for me too, I was kind of like, well, I'm in Gorguts, I'm not gonna go, I don't know, I felt like I should kind of rein it in at times and like not go crazy. And I feel like on this one, we're going a bit like, let's just get crazy with it, you know? And well, still like, you know, I mean, making a coherent piece of music and stuff, you know, but we definitely experimented a lot more this time, I guess is what I'm saying. And trying some more radical ideas and approaches.
It's a long process, you know. Same thing with lyrics, you know. It took a long time to find a theme. It's all about you just let it go, and everything just sits in place at the right time.
I think it's also important for this band too, and something we thought about is like we don't want to make it. The band's never made a part two kind of record, you know. It's always been something different every time, and I feel like the band's done that again. Like cause it would have been pretty easy, and I was like, wondering if what we were going to write next would sound too similar to Colored Sands, but it really doesn't, and we're all really happy with that. Just the fact that you feel like we made another record that doesn't sound like the previous one, you know? Because that was always what I loved about the band before I joined it. It's just how you just kind of never knew what you were going to get with the next record. You know?